Hello Strutters, Dan here, playing Naya Burn, now with 4 Arid Mises. Alright, my opponent is Amaran Kauran 0526. I have a 2-lander, I have Swift Spears, I will keep it. I will do some damage. So, when I have 3 lands, maybe, and no red or white cards, maybe I should always start with getting a mountain. I have Stomping Ground. Is there a point to getting... Who plays Polluted Delta? There is another land. Okay, let's use the Arid Mises again. And get the Swift Spear out there. Doing his thing. Am I too slow suspending Rift Bolts? Maybe I am. Yeah, and then you do damage to yourself with your Delta. Yes, please. Did it hurt? I hope it hurt. It's Steam Wends, it's Splinter Twin! No, it isn't Splinter Twin. I don't know what it is. But I will... Oh god, so many lands. So I want to get value out of Paths of Exiles and stuff. So here I just want to play Swift Spear and Bolt. And I will get the Sacred Foundry now. But way too many lands. Of course he can bolt one of these. That's a very likely outcome. I think I'm gonna lose here because I have no business left in the deck. Drawing land, land, land. There's the bolt. There's another bolt. He spell pierces the bolt. I still get the prowess trigger. It's quite a bit of damage on him anyway. But now I don't have anything. And I draw another land, so... I am just gonna swing here and suspend the Rift Bolt. Should have cast it. Sigh. Or maybe I just cast it in his face. What if he spell pierces it? He has 3 cards left. Now I think I'm gonna suspend it. But this does not look good. But I think pretty much in any game where I draw 6 lands this early, I'm gonna lose. Sorry for my voice. I spent the night with cats that I shouldn't have. I am allergic. Cast it, targeting him. And there is Satarka's command. I should be getting some lands at the end of turn here. Now I can't cast Satarka's command. But I can just go get it, right? Yeah, I misplayed that horribly. I should have played the Stomping Ground. So I'm getting lands here and I'm casting Satarka's command next turn. And now at least I'm gonna get business. I'm getting, I don't know, the Sacred Foundry. Oh my god! Not much going on here, but I have to sit back. He is not threatening me. We got no evidence of that he is a combo deck. So I should probably just collect enough stuff. This lava monster feels not very powerful. I'm saving the Misa. Snap custom edge. That's irritating. And then he's gonna bolt my face. Well, it's better that he bolts my face than he bolts Lava Mancer. This is where I Atarkas command him, right? Because we are in the first game. Yeah, I'm putting a land card from my hand onto the battlefield. Oh, yeah, this is the one. Oh, crap. Main deck dispel. Three cards left. Probably some removal spell. I have one mountain left that I can go get. There's another Atarkas command. How long time do I have? Bolt, attack, attack, attack. I have three turns. Perhaps. So I could possibly wait a turn. What does that accomplish? Not a whole lot. But I'm gonna wait a turn. To put more pressure on him with more business. But I am at the real risk of dying here. Inquisition of Kozilek was not what I expected, so I will cast this. And he will snap cast the dispel. Yeah, I've totally lost control here. Or rather, he has gained control. I would say he's just playing Grixis control. Which my sideboard plan says I should not sideboard against. And it's probably correct. Not dead yet, he's tapped out, so let's just hit him. But how do I do 5 damage? I can't do that, so I will still die. I will die right now if you can do 1 damage. Interesting. Yeah, and that's it. I'm still gonna go with the no sideboard plan. Yeah, let me know what you think. There are definitely some questionable cards here. I'll make some notes while I'm waiting for him. 16 Amarakauran. Grixis control. I am playing a land light version of the deck. There is a difference of one land and people like debate which number is the correct one. I think it's 19 and 20, and I'm playing the lighter. I'm playing first. Got a two land hand. Lightning Helix is not the optimal card against him. But I'm of course going to keep this. And I am going to do a lot of damage to myself. I'm going to use the Eremisa, get the Sacred Foundry for Boris Charm and Lightning Helix. And pay for it. Pay dearly for it. Swing. He reveals Painful Truths. I don't know what that is. Painful Truths, MTG. You draw X cards and you lose X life. Why do you keep that in against Burn? That seems weird. So now I guess it's just a Boris Charm next turn. In his sweet face. Is he going to Inquisition me? Probably. Taking Lightning Bolt, I guess, or Boris Charm. Yeah. So I guess I'm casting Boris Charm here. Now I can afford to get a lonely mountain. A normal mountain. And I will. And I will cast Boris Charm while he's tapped out. And I really hope I don't draw any more lands. Goblin Guide, best card in the deck. Uh-oh, except when he runs into Lightning Bolt. But getting a red man will probably cost him a lot of life here. Got 6 damage in hand. Does he have a real mountain? No, he doesn't. Dragon's Claw is too late, I think. Not sure about that. And I draw another land, damn it. If I just cast all the spells, I do 5 damage to him. And I think I should just cast the spells now, when I can. So I'm getting the red-green land, paying for it, because I want to have a mountain in my deck for path. And I'm just hitting him with everything here. Of course he gains 3 life then. But it is at 4. Still getting a red mana will cost him. No, he had a basic mountain, of course he did. Oh my god, double Dragon's Claw. Okay, then I have to bring in the stuff. But now I can kill him, right? I just attack, he tries to gain the life. No, he does survive it. Which is a disaster. Anger of the Gods. So now he bolts, he gains 2 life. Yeah, I'm gonna be 1 from. Oh, now I... Yeah. Hey, permanence or control gain indestructible. That doesn't do a whole lot here. It lives. He goes to 5. Actually, if he can't deal with it any other way, that's kind of my hope here. Doing the Boris Charm thing doesn't do a whole lot. He will end up at 3. He can just snapcast a mage, bolt it, so I'm doing it that way. I should probably not yield to the Dragon Claws. So he goes to 3 here. Yeah. I think he's got me again. Yeah, how do I... How do I deal with this? I have to... That's kind of interesting. Let's try that. Snapcast Mage Bolt is just a lot of life here. Or at least it takes 4 damage for it, so... Do you think he has mana leaks? If he does, I'm pretty doomed. So Snapcast the Mage Bolt is going to cost it, but now you... Oh, that's clever. Yeah, but then he gains 2 life. Yeah, of course. And now he bolts and it just ends up doing... Stone nothing. Yeah, I think he's got this one too. I would suspect we were super favored in this matchup. And I'm reluctant to bring in the artifact destruction against decks with just 4 artifacts, but in this case, maybe it's too big. But I didn't know he had Dragon's Claws. Only my 7th loss with the deck. Wow, Swiss Spear really doesn't do anything here, but let's do it. We gotta try. Why did I speak about Path Exiles when I knew he wasn't white? Of course, you never know for sure. He bolts me and I can't get out of range for that. So, yeah, I am pretty screwed here. I do have time though, so maybe I should have been gathering more spells. Yeah, I should have. I was way too defeatist there. The fact that he gains 2 life out of any spell I cast, some of the spells that he casts, that's just impossible to overcome, I think. There actually does painful truths. So I can skullcrack shard volley in response to something he does. But of course now he has dispels and stuff. I should probably be getting at least one land. But why? I should. Skullcrack. He still gains life for Skullcrack. So Skullcrack does 1 damage. I do 4 damage if he doesn't have a counterspell. So maybe this is the time to try it. I don't think I get many more chances. And he had a dispel, so that didn't do much. I should have done it in response to Painful Truths. Yeah. It's hard to defeat a defeatist me. I feel that I'm controlled, and that's not a common feeling in Modern. Let me know how I should have done better, and how you think I should have sideboarded. So I'm getting a land at least. Let's say a Sacred Foundry. And I think I have to try to blaze him here. We haven't seen mana leaks. No, I'm getting the mountain. Now I'm just trying to defend myself. But he has another dispel, which is pretty good against burn. Yeah, it's over. There's even a lightning bolt in his graveyard. So it should end right here. Well, there is nothing I can do. Pretty much no need to cast that. And here comes the Snapcaster Mage, so that's it. Thank you for watching, and we chalk up a defeat. 0-2 against Grixis Control. I felt like I had no chance. What do you think of the matchup? Let me know if you're playing the control player or the burn player. Let me know what you think. This seemed pretty hard. Maybe he was extremely lucky. Thank you for watching.